Hey everybody! I'm here today to show you and tell you how to use a Timex Expedition digital watch. This will be a full tutorial, so let's get right into the video. As you can see right here, this is my new Timex Expedition digital watch, and this will be a full tutorial showing you how to use it. Really, really simple and straightforward. There are essentially five buttons. You have four buttons on the outside here, on the outside corners, and then you have your Indiglo button over here, and then you have the information on the screen. So I'm going to show you how to sort of use all of those things. So first and foremost, how do you read the watch? Well, let's take a look at the screen right here. I'm going to light it up. So we have the time right here, which includes the number of seconds. We also have the day of the week up here. We have the month, and then we have the day of the month. So I didn't set this. This is not correct right now. I'm filming this towards the end of November 2022. You know, this is saying, I think it's set to like 2016 or something like that. But it's saying it's Friday. Okay, it's saying it's Friday. It's reversed on my screen over here. It's saying it's Friday, December 16th, and it's saying that it's 9:44 and that many seconds a.m., okay? So that's what it's saying. That's how you read the screen. Very simple and straightforward. Now, how to set the screen? How do you set the time and the date options? Well, essentially, there's a set button over here, as you can see. We're gonna hold down the set button, okay? And it says hold to set. And then now we can set either time one or time two. So let's set time one, okay? So to set time one, I'm gonna push set, okay? Sorry about that. That took me out of the set menu. I do apologize. Hold down set to get back to the set menu. Now we're gonna set time one. Now it shows next is this button over here. So I'm gonna push this to set time one to go to the next screen. You can go up or down, okay, like this. Go up or down to change the time, as you can see, just like that. And then when you're done going up or down, you can push next. Same thing with the number of minutes. When you're done going up or down, push next. And then the same thing with the number of seconds. Push next when you're done. Then you can set the month, so you can go up or down. Push next when you're done. And then the day of the month. Push next when you're done. Then it's gonna show the year. You can set the year. Go up or down with these buttons. And then push next when you're done. Okay, do you want a 12-hour or a 24-hour clock? Go up or down to select, push next when you're done. It's showing the date format. How do you want the date to be shown? Choose it and then push next when you're done. Do you want the chime, the hourly chime on or off? Choose it, push next when you're done. And then do you want the beep on or off? Okay, which is when you push the buttons, it beeps. Choose it and then push next when you're done, okay? And then when you're done everything, it's taking you back to the first menu now for setting time one or time two. You're gonna push done up here. You can see it says done right over here. I'm gonna push done and it brings me back to that screen. So that's pretty much the most complicated aspect of using this watch, setting the time and date and functions like that, okay? Next up, I wanna show you how to go between the modes. So from this main screen right here, you can push this to go between the modes. So you can go to chronograph, timer, set your alarm one, alarm two, or alarm three. And that's back to the main screen. So let's go over each of those options. So chronograph is very simple. On the chronograph feature right here, you can start and split right here. So you can, like, it says start and split, stop and reset. So I can start by pushing this button up here. I can stop it like this, and then I can reset it like that. Okay, very simple. I can hold it to reset. And now I've reset the chronograph. Very simple. So start is the top button over here. Stop is the bottom one over here, and you can split it if you want as well by going like that. So I can split it, stop it, and then when it's stopped, you can hold this to reset, and you've now reset the chronograph right back to the start again. Okay, the next mode that I want to show you is the timer. Very simple. For a timer, you can set the timer and you start it and stop it. Very simple, very straightforward. I mean, there's really not much to it, but you can set the timer. So I can go and I can set the timer by holding this down, set the amount of time that you want. When you choose how much time that you want on the timer, you can start it and stop it with these buttons over here. I'm gonna go to the next mode. We're gonna keep moving forward. So I'm gonna go from chrono, timer, to alarm one. Alarm one, two, and three are all gonna be the same way of using them, but I'm just gonna show you alarm one. So right now it's off. You wanna change it to on, you're gonna use these buttons over here. So I'm gonna change it to on, and it's set for daily, okay? Off or daily. Now you can also change the options for the alarm with regards to the time and how often it will go off by holding the set button. So I'm gonna hold the set button down, okay? And now I can set alarm over here. So I can set the time of the alarm, whatever I want to do right here. So I'm going to push next. So let's say I wanted it at 12 o'clock PM, which is what it's set to right now, 12 o'clock PM. And then I can choose daily by pushing these buttons over here, daily or weekdays. Sorry, it's reversed on the screen. Weekdays or weekends only. So daily is every day. Weekdays is Monday through Friday. Weekends is Saturday and Sunday. Very simple. Okay. And when you're done setting it, you push done over here. Okay. And now your alarm is set. And once again, to toggle it on or off, you just push this button right here and it'll go between off or daily or weekends or weekdays, whatever you have it set to. Okay, to go off and on to whatever setting you have chosen. Very simple. I'm gonna turn it off so it doesn't go off. The alarm doesn't go off, I mean. By turning it off, the alarm won't go off, if that makes any sense. I think it does. Last but not least, let's go back to the main time screen over here. Okay, after alarm three, we go back to the main time screen. The last thing is to use the indigo feature, which I'm gonna push it, and you can see it lights up. Really, really sleek feature. Just push the button, it lights up for a few seconds. All you need is a few seconds to read that screen. And that's for battery life preservation. You don't want it to light up for so long, because then you basically are gonna drain your battery faster. And that's basically it. I've shown you how to read the screen, how to change between the modes, how to set the different options for the modes, and how to set the option for the actual time and date on the screen, and how to use the Indiglo feature. And that's essentially it. That is how to use a Timex Expedition digital watch, a full tutorial. I've gone over pretty much everything other than putting it on, which is simple. You put it on, you put the strap through. I mean, I don't really have to, I shouldn't have to show you that. Very straightforward. It's an awesome watch, and I've shown you exactly how to use it in this video. If you like this video tutorial/demonstration/explanation, please be sure to give it a nice big thumbs up, a double thumbs up. Let me know what you think down below as a comment, and of course be sure to subscribe for more great videos just like this one. And that's all I have for you today. Thanks for watching.